Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England, the houses so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to get married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad, then be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, my dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I suppose that he never will learn. And because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of. And now we've nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy you've named a child for her, although she's got six of her own. And you say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you will be coming home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1880, dear Michael and John, my sons. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother has gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. And you don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's good to hear that Michael's returning. With money he's sure to buy land, for the crop has been poor, and the people are selling at any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, my dear and loving son John. I guess that I must be close on to 80, it's 30 years since you've gone. Because of all the money you send me, I'm still living out on my own. And Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters are grown. And thank you for sending your family picture, their lovely young women and men. And you say that you might even come for a visit. What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892, my dear brother John. I'm sorry that I didn't write sooner to tell you that father passed on. He was living with Bridget, she says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. I should have seen him play with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. And he was a strong and a feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny the way he kept talking about you. He called for you in